a link between stress and pain, but what is stress? What is the difference between being stressed, worried, or having anxiety? Is there a treatment for stress and anxiety? And is it possible to reduce pain by managing our stress levels? I will answer this and other questions in this video today. So let's talk about stress and pain today. First, let's define stress. According to the psychologists and experts in mental health, stress is a subjective feeling that we have when we feel we can't cope with the situation we are facing. It is a natural human reaction when we are faced with a challenge that we think it is too much for us to tolerate. It is different from fear. Fear is an instinctive reaction that is present in other animals too. It is a spontaneous reaction because it is controlled by the autonomic nervous system. I explained the autonomic nervous system in another video, but basically the autonomic nervous system has two opposing systems, the sympathetic and the parasympathetic nervous system. The sympathetic part is responsible for the quick reaction when we are faced with a real or perceived threat. When activated, it starts the fight or flight or flee reaction. On the other hand, the parasympathetic part is active in situations of rest, digestion, and healing from an injury. So the two parts of the autonomic nervous system cannot be active at the same time. A person cannot be fighting a tiger and resting at the same time. Worry is different. Only humans worry. The other animals have fear, but they don't worry. Worry is a repetitive and recurring thought. It's when we try to avoid something that is uncomfortable to us. It could be a feeling, a fear, or an emotion. Now, anxiety is when there is excessive fear, especially about something that is vague, intangible, out of control, and it affects our ability to function normally. So, for example, a person may feel stress because they have too many demands, a little time or energy to cope with them. If this stressful situation persists, the person may start worrying about these demands, and worry and preoccupation will occupy their thoughts most of the time. Now, because they are spending a lot of energy worrying and preoccupied, they have even less time and energy to finish the tasks that were causing the stress in the first place. And if they develop anxiety, which is an excessive fear, this may aggravate worry and will not help with coping with stress. So it is very important to identify those thoughts and emotions early when they appear to avoid that they feed each other. And now, how does pain get into this equation? Pain is part of the body's alarm system to detect danger. Pain is the sound alarm that makes noise when there is something broken, cut, damaged, or injured. But our body has other mechanisms to detect danger, and fear is another way to protect us. When our brain perceives something as dangerous, a tiger, a lion, or a bear, it triggers the sympathetic nervous system to respond with either fighting, flying, or fleeing. It releases adrenaline in the blood and accelerates the heart, increases the blood pressure, sends more oxygen to the muscles so you can run or fight. Another defense mechanism is the immune system. We have an army of immune cells circulating every single corner of our body 24 hours a day. They are there to detect microbes like viruses, bacteria, and fungus that could kill us. And finally, we also have our senses, vision, hearing, skin sensors for temperature, to cold, to hot, that will alert our brain if we are in danger or not. So, all of these systems are integrated. They all work in harmony until the day that they don't. If one of these protective systems are malfunctioning, the others will be affected. And here, it is how pain and stress are so interrelated. If the pain system is malfunctioning, like in the case of central sensitization, the pain alarm will be a false alarm, but the brain doesn't know that. The brain detects danger, and pain is a very strong reason to stress the brain and activate the sympathetic nervous system. This is especially relevant when the person feels that they can't cope with it, that the pain is too much for them. Then the person will start worrying more about pain, their future, their life, their dreams, their job. They develop fear of pain, which is a very natural reaction, given that the symptom is not going away. There must be something really serious, they think. And then, before they realize, they develop anxiety. In some cases, this anxiety can be so severe that it impacts many areas of their lives. They avoid going out of their house. They stop interacting with other people. They don't have a regular sleep routine. And they stop living their lives. The opposite can be true. The person doesn't start with pain, but with stress. They might have had adverse childhood experiences, post-traumatic stress disorders. They may have been exposed to abuse, bullying, or even being the type of person who wants to please everyone, can't say no, and is perfectionist. They may develop fear of abandonment, fear of rejection, fear of loneliness, fear of financial loss, and before they notice, they develop the disease of anxiety. Then they enter into a regular, irregular sleep cycle, do not eat proper, nutritious meals, stop physical activity, isolate themselves, use substances like nicotine, cannabis, alcohol, or drugs to numb their emotions and thoughts. And all these poor lifestyle changes are an excellent ground for pain. If the person starts messing up with their sleep routine, this is by itself sufficient to start pain, especially nociplastic pain. If you are a doctor and want to learn more about nociplastic pain, I want to give you this free handout that I use to explain the difference between neuropathic and nociplastic pain to my medical students and residents. Just follow the link in the description below. Now let's talk about what a person can do when they realize they are in this roundabout of stress, worry, fear, anxiety, and pain. There are lots of strategies to get the person out of this. Before I continue, let me remind you that this video is not intended to provide medical advice. It is for educational purposes only. If you think that you have a problem with stress, worry, fear, or anxiety, please talk to your doctor. If there is an emergency, please go to the nearest emergency department or call an ambulance. First is to recognize they are in this roundabout. If the person denies this is happening to them, there is very little we can do to help. The most common symptoms of anxiety include irritability, tiredness, lack of motivation, headaches, feeling sad, crying, stomach or bowel upset, muscle pains, or changing appetite, too much or too little. Second, medications can help for a while, especially if the anxiety becomes too serious and affects the whole life of the individual. In these cases, the person will need to seek care from a doctor specialized in anxiety treatment, usually psychiatrists or neurologists. Third, remember that stress is part of our normal life. Worry and preoccupation are part of being human beings. We can all learn how to live a life that has less demands, our calendars are less cluttered, our homes are more organized, and we have time for rest and relax. Maybe all the person needs is to take a personal organizer, a coach, a mentor, a relative, or a friend. Be open to suggestions and be prepared to say no more often. Self-care is important. Remember, in the airplane, they always say put the oxygen mask on yourself first before you try to help someone else with their masks. Fourth, a life without a bit of stress is boring. A little bit of stress is good. Adrenaline will get us moving. With stress, we'll be more excited, more awake, feel more alive. The problem is not stress. The problem is too much stress that the person perceives they can't cope anymore. Many people would say that if it was not for stress, they would not have been courageous, brave, or take the steps to change their life for the better. So, think of stress as your friend who is pushing you to move forward in life. Fifth, here are some suggestions that the person could try to alleviate stress, worry, fear, and anxiety. Talk to a professional counselor. Find a psychologist, a psychiatrist, a counselor, or a mental health professional. If work is a major source of stress, worry, fear, anxiety, talk to the manager, human resource staff, or employee assistance programs. If family relationships are a major source of stress, seek a marital counselor, a family counseling, or a trusted mentor or friend. If finances are a major source of stress, seek help from a financial advisor. If they don't have enough time to do all they must do, learn some skills in time management and project management. If clutter and hoarding is a source of stress, they can learn how to clean the house, the office, establishing purge days, buy less and donate more. Get a journal and start writing about their thoughts and emotions. Reducing exposure to media, social media, electronics, radio and TV. Choose to spend time in activities that do not overstimulate their brain, like reading a book, doing a craft, playing an instrument, singing, dancing, walking, or talking to friends. Practice mindfulness, mindful movements, and mindful eating. Start a meditation or a relaxation routine. Practice forgiveness. Many religions recommend forgiveness, and although this practice takes an emotional effort, the end result is reduction of stress, worry, fear, and anxiety. Reduce sympathetic drive by activating the parasympathetic nervous system. Prioritize a sleep routine. Try progressive muscle relaxation to combat insomnia. Avoid foods that aggravate stress, like processed or ultra-processed foods, refined sugars, caffeine, alcohol, and artificial sweeteners, and schedule free time in their agenda. I prepared some videos to guide people in meditation, mindfulness, progressive muscle relaxation, box breathing, and many more exercises to reduce stress, worry, fear, and anxiety. They are in the course area of my YouTube channel. The videos do not have any advertisements, so the person can practice these activities without interruption. Here is the link to the course area. And don't forget to subscribe to this channel and turn on the notifications button so you can be alerted when I post new videos here. Thank you for watching. Bye.